earlier categorically denied that there was a walkout during the July 4th command conference, but former Executive Secretary Vic Rodriguez claimed in his recently published book that some members of the military are quite unhappy with how President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has been appointing several officials, former generals, to key posts without the consent of other generals, particularly the AFP commander, the AFP chief of staff, as well as the former head of the DND. How accurate is the claim that there are members of the AFP that are quite disgruntled with the current administration?
Yes, Katrina, let me put into context again the supposed incident about the officers of the AFP walking out of the recent command conference held last July 4 is pure fallacy. Now, this news is a sheer pigment of one's wild imagination, and this never occurred. For the Armed Forces of the Philippines, we are asking each and everyone to not be swayed by false narratives that seek to divide us, but instead strengthen our resolve to serve the Philippines with honor and courage. This coming out is not actually true, because the generals of the AFP, together, of course, led by our chief of staff, been going around all of the units, even our lower units. And we have been talking to our troops most of the time, especially when there are recent incidents that have major activities that occurred, the major operations. And the morale and the state of morale of our troops is very high. We rest assured that the Armed Forces of the Philippines is united, and that they are very much professional.
All right. Colonel Padilla, we all know that when talk or rumors about disgruntled AFP members arise, it's usually followed by rumors of a coup. What do you make out of the timing of this issue? It comes days ahead of the president's third State of the Nation address.
With this, spreading baseless rumors not only undermines the integrity of our armed forces, but it also disrespects the sacrifices made by every soldier in the line of duty. In the Armed Forces of the Philippines, we remain steadfast and resolute, and we are driven by an unwavering love for our country and a dedication to protect our people. In fact, when we had our last visit to WESCOM, our chief of staff spoke to the troops that were involved and those who are deployed to the seven features and two islands in the West Philippine Sea. And their fighting spirit is really very high. And we thank the Filipino people because of the support that they are giving to the Armed Forces of the Philippines, which gives us, ignites the flame of patriotism of every soldier.
Okay, so what about rumors of a coup? What do you make out of these talk, the timing?
These are main rumors, and these rumors we do not let it affect how we perform our duty and our mission in the Armed Forces of the Philippines. We are professional and we are united.
All right, Colonel Padilla, does the AFP plan to pursue cases against those who have been peddling this fake narrative?
We will not tolerate these efforts to malign our ranks or discredit our commitment to our mandate. So as we speak, we are exploring legal avenues to address this affront to the military profession.
And sino-sino po yung magiging respondents of this planned case so far? Is it just limited to those who spoke about this in a radio interview, or will you go down to as far as a person who they supposedly said was a former general who posted something on his Facebook, I think, or a vlog?
With this, ang reaction po ng Armed Forces of the Philippines dyan, we are going to explore each avenue of approach on how to handle this situation. And of course, matapang naming binabatikos, the false narrative that was put out there by one of our retired officers. This incident that happened, they gave it a wrong interpretation from a blind item. And so we consider this as an irresponsible, and this should not have occurred, especially being done by a former officer of the armed forces.
Okay.
This is baseless, and this seeks to divide the AFP, and we do not deal with political matters.
Would you go to as far as saying that these statements are libelous in nature?
As I said, we will look at all of the possible legal implications of this incident.
All right. Colonel Padilla, aside from the possible filing of charges against fake news peddlers, what else is the AFP doing to stop the spread of false narratives about the institution?
We're looking at different approaches as far as even fact-checking all of the posts that involves the Armed Forces of the Philippines. We are also coordinating with different agencies and in terms of law enforcement. And of course, we are also strengthening our cybersecurity posture.
All right. Finally, Colonel Padilla, as we wrap up this interview, what does the military want to hear in President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s third SONA?
Of course, we would be anticipating the support of our Commander-in-Chief to the Armed Forces of the Philippines moving forward as we transition from internal security operations towards territorial defense, and how the government and the whole of government would be one with the AFP, of course, in this mission of safeguarding our people and, of course, our sovereignty in general.
And with that, thank you so much for joining us this morning, AFP spokesperson Colonel Francel Margareth Padilla.
Thank you, Katrina, and good morning.